Hello, and welcome back. We have right angle triangle ABC, for which we have listed all the calculated values of the IY. For the IY at the intersection of the base and hypotenuse, we assume the YX called Y1, and the value of the moment of inertia at Y1 equal to HB cubed divided by 4. While if we take another yx, let us call it y2, passing by bc, the opposite side, we have calculated that iy2 equal to hb cubed divided by 12. Remember that our cg for this right angle triangle is located at 2/3 of b from the y1 axis and 1/3 of b from the y2 axis at the horizontal distances, and while for the vertical distance, it is located 1/3 of h from the base AB. Now, we want to check that the calculation of the moment of inertia for both y1 and y2 are correct. If they will give us the same value of the moment of inertia at the CG in the y direction. Starting from the moment of inertia estimated for the y1 axis, we have iy1 equal to hb cubed divided by 4. If we want to get the expression of moment of inertia for y dash, which is a vertical axis passing by the CG, then we are going to subtract the multiplication of the area by square of the x bar squared. So our iycg calculated from the data given by the IY1 equal to HB cubed divided by 4 minus open bracket 1/2 BH, which is the area, multiplied by the square of 2/3 B, which is 4/9 B squared. So our IYCG is HB cubed over 4 minus 2/9 B cubed H. We are going to subtract, and finally we get the value of HB cubed over 36. From the other side, which is Y2, we want to estimate also the moment of inertia at the Y direction for the CG, but our distance, the horizontal distance in this case, will be only B divided by 3. And our IY2 is HB cubed divided by 12. So the IYCG equal to the IY2 minus the area multiplied by the square of the distance, which is 1/3 B. Then we have HB cubed over 12 minus open bracket 1/2 BH multiplied by the square of 1/3 B. It will come at the end HB cubed multiplied by 1/12 minus 1/18. Which will give us HB cubed over 36. Comparing these two values, we find that our calculation for the moment of inertia for Y at CG is correct. Hence, we can calculate the radius of gyration by using the expression K square Y CG equal to the IY CG divided by the area, which is HB cubed over 36 divided by 1/2 BH, which will give us B square over 18. Now, after we have calculated the moment of inertia in X and Y respectively, we can estimate the polar moment of inertia at corners for the IX equal to BH cubed over 12 and IY is HB cubed over 4. For the polar moment of inertia, we are going to sum these two values. So, and we denote this polar by G naught. So we'll add BH cubed over 12 plus HB cubed over 4. Adjusting the denominator as 12, we get 1/3 BH multiplied by H squared plus B squared. If we are going to estimate the polar moment of inertia at the CG, Then we will add the two values of the ix at cg plus the iy at cg. We have bh cubed over 36 as ix at the g, and iyg is hb cubed over 36. Adding them together, we will get that the polar moment of inertia at the cg is bh open bracket h squared plus b squared all divided by 36. But in case that you would like to evaluate the polar moment of inertia at point B, then the value will be different from point A, provided that the Ix equal to BH cubed over 12, while the Iy is smaller than the Iy calculated at point A, and the value is HB cubed over 12. Adding together, we get the G naught at point B equal to 1 over 12 HB multiplied by H squared B squared. Thanks a lot and see you. Goodbye.